Okay, I think this is part 5 or 6, I can't remember right now, but this is for me. I gotta take this wiring harness off. I've never done it. But I can see there's one bolt in there. I just wanna document, even though these wires aren't right, what goes where. So just starting here. This is the cruise control. I can see there's a wire off here. This wire might go here to the fuse. It says light. Then this, with the writing on top, says hold, engage, light. The cable on the bottom goes to the transmission. And the cable on top is going into the car. Again, we're on top. There's a vacuum hose here that's going around to here. The top vacuum hose goes to this T. No, not the top vacuum hose. Actually, there's two slots here. The slot right there. Again, that's the top. There's a hose back here. This hose, there's two lines. The one on this side goes to here. Top one, right there, isn't going anywhere right now. Then I'm going to pull this harness out over here. Well, move the camera. Go, but this is better than nothing. So that harness is coming over here with a red and black. I guess I need a screwdriver. So red and black, goes to here. Dental tool. Like I say, I don't pull off until I have to, and now I have to. Getting back to over here, I don't know if I can see it. wiper motor, I guess. Wiper motor, cable's running. Green on top. Looks like the two blacks on the bottom. I guess I gotta get all this stuff out of my way. It's just driving me nuts anyway. This battery doesn't last as long when it gets cold out on the camera. Okay, the vacuum hose from this T. That's in the picture. Yeah. Vacuum hose from this T. Going over to the cruise control. Might as well disconnect that. Pliers. Diaphragm in here. Sounds like it's still good. And this goes to the carburetor. I don't have the bracket for that, it's missing. Because the manifold is missing. This wire just, this hose just stuck in here. I assume that coil it was. Wedged in there. This cable here is just, I'm holding the back of the block up. There's no transmission.
Trying to look through the viewfinder here. Let's see. Here. Power is about right of the master cylinder, so I'm too low. Okay, hang on. How do you get the right tool?
nut in there. Bolt, I mean. Yeah, I just dropped my socket. There it is. Comes all the way out or not. Like it wants to come out more. There. Okay, I'm gonna have to disconnect some of this stuff. Cruise control. So, had pliers. What do I do with them? Probably right in front of me. Damn it. Okay. You know, when I was in construction, I'm just talking the whole time here. We always had like an apprentice with us. If you watch, half the time is spent just walking back and forth, getting tools. I was watching YouTube with Eric, the car guy. And I guess he gave up on his company. But I noticed he's always working alone. Okay, so I think I said this before, but this top one is going into the car, into the firewall in there. And this bottom one is the one that goes to the transmission. Anyway, if I was the start of an auto mechanic business, I just have some kid and I don't care what I can get. Just keep getting me parts or tools. Okay, this is a speedometer cable. Let me see. So this is the end. I don't know if there's a difference. Let's look. Different ends. Well, I guess it's obvious, but the small bolt goes here. And you can see it is turning, it's not broken. These are the kind of things though you should grease or oil, just hang it up. Put like a bag, let oil drip all the way through this cable. Re-lube it while it's on. I'm going to disconnect everything that I... Okay, this is the, again, I'm going to say it again, this is the top. Well, look at this vacuum hose. Again, I don't know where this stuff goes now. I don't assume it goes to the carburetor. Here's the other end of it. The other end has a clip on it. This one doesn't. That one doesn't. I'm going to disconnect it. So, it's the bottom T. See what else is on here. There's a wire that goes in right above the firewall. This is a weird cable. It almost looks like a vacuum. I gotta disconnect it, so looks like a red or a brown and a black. The black is going to engage, the red brown, whatever it is going to hold. It's not plastic, it's Bakelite or something. Anyway, I think it's red. Part of this. Harness right here. Harness. So looking down in here, shot my flashlight down in there. Which is the reason I took all this stuff out. See if you can see it. I'll just zoom in. When I say you, that means us, me. Yeah, you can see it. Sock in there, so that's gonna have to be a wrench. On the other side, and underneath, there's gonna be something to disconnect. Mostly it goes with the brake bow. So I probably should disconnect that first. I'm not gonna really get a shot of that. Or maybe I will. If I do, it's gonna be a bank. Handheld. There's 19 in there. These aren't used. Okay, there were 19 here, 17 here, I think I said. So all I gotta do now to disconnect this master, which I reordered, which I need to do to hook up the brake lines. That's why I'm doing this right now. I gotta disconnect. Put the vacuum that goes to the carburetor. I think they call it, I forget the name, I think it's called a vacuum booster. That's it. So if I remember correctly from before, to remind myself later. One of the wires goes to the top of the proportion valve, and that was that's just a push on. The reason I'm The reason I'm taking this off now, I mean, I gotta do this sooner or later. Then I can clean up the back of this firewall, which I never did. I cleaned it up from there to here. But I gotta run the lines right into here. So I gotta get this into place and start putting it back together. I guess I'll try to. You know, I just want to show you guys this lift, if you buy a lift. Okay, watch me. I'm going to open the door. The problem with this lift, there's that much room. I mean, there's more room down here. I'm pretty, you know, like I said, I'm pretty chunky now. But the point is, there's a show. They have these new lifts that have articulating arms, and they get and gives you about that much space. So I think you could open your door. You could see one on the show. What's the name of that show? Wheeler Dealers. They got one. If I was to buy, this lift came with the shop, but if I was to have to buy another lift, I'd get one of those kind. They set further apart. The other thing I don't like about this lift, I mean, it came with the shop, I'm just getting sidetracked as usual. To lower this lift, I don't know if you see this cable down there, you gotta pull that cable down on both sides. I had another lift in another house. There was a lever. Just lower the lever. This, you have to pull there. So I get a lift that had the articulating arms with a good lever. Anyway, sidetracked.
Oh, so the reason I was talking about the door, I just turned the camera back on. So I gotta squeeze through that hole to get in there to disconnect this master cylinder. But we know damn well that no matter how many tools I take, there's gonna be one more that I need. So it'd be nice to be able to get in easy, in and out easier, or it'd be nice to have a helper if you had a shop. No matter what he was paid, you just try. In construction, I trained all my apprentices. They never went to apprentice school. You just start them out with the very basic, and as you need more help, they learn. And pretty soon, they end up really good, really fast. Okay, I'm inside the car. The only way to see up in there is lay on my back. First thing I noticed, this pedal, it's frozen. I doubt they had any kind of lockout feature back then. Let's move the shifter. Anyway. I don't want to get in and out of here three times. I think I'll go look at the manual. Hopefully it says how to disconnect it. Meaning, I don't want to get in and out three or four times. Hopefully it says the right tool. Okay, I got the manual out. Let's see. So it says F series. There's the four bolts. There's the thing that mounts to the dash, I guess, that puts the four bolts through. This isn't real clear. Yeah, I guess it is. Spacer part of dash reinforcement. It must be, I gotta disconnect that right there, and it says retainer must scribe a line on end of pin and snap in place when assembling and groove pin. Retainer must scribe a line on end of pin and snap in place an assembled and groove pin. That's an interesting statement. But looking at this, looks like there's just a retainer. That's the only thing I gotta take off. So I just need a pair of pliers and a screwdriver. I'm hoping. But you notice there's another bolt there. It doesn't say what it's for. Oops. There's the pin here, and then there's something else here. So it looks like a nut. So I'm gonna do this on my back, upside down. So that's it. I don't know if you could see that, but there it is. So you gotta watch out in these manuals. I got F, X, B, X, A, and G. Some have better pictures than others. Looking through this manual right now. See if it actually says remove master cylinder. Pedal. Brake warning light. That must be what that. Brake warning caution. Must take air from inner hydraulic system. That must be what that. Switch on the proportion valve is. But I can't see where it says anything about the master cylinder. That's what I don't like. Well, here it is, removed. Disconnect master cylinder, push rod from brake pedal, accept power brakes. Well, I got power brakes. Disconnect brake lines. I did that. Remove master cylinder. From dash, from booster with power brakes. Remove master cylinder reservoir cover. A retainer push rod is used on all standard brakes. It's a pullback boot to uncover push rod retainer. A retainer is a small depressed tab on the side, which may be pried up to release retainer. Tab serves to hold retainer and push rod on master cylinder, which is being shipped and is not necessary to bend tab down at reassembly. Retainer is held in place between master cylinder and dash from master cylinder is bolted in place. Remove small secondary piston stop bolt from bottom or front. Okay. So. Pull back boot to uncover push rod retainer. I don't know if that's talking about under the dash. One more time. All standard brake. Pull back boot to uncover push rod retainer. Looks like it's just a clip. Okay, I'm laying on my back. Just push the button on the camera. Anyway, I'm trying to get my hand in there. I think it's this clip right here. I can't do it with one hand, but anyway, here's the rod coming down from the master cylinder. And I think I'm pushing the pedal. I think this master cylinder is frozen anyway.
or the power booster or whatever. So, because the pedal only moves an eighth of an inch, quarter inch. Okay, that's it.
Okay. 9/16. I got one of them loose. It was freaking tight. You hear that? Man, it's like torqued way down. Of course, I don't have a ratchet wrench. Anyway. The other side. I'm gonna take out the wiper motor. It's tight. Anyway, I won't bore you with that, but here's. So I do have to take out the wiper motor. You got a flashlight. Where am I? Again, it's hard to look through this damn thing. There it is. So if I gotta take the wiper motor out. Looks like it's just, if you can still see, looks like it's just a bolt here, here, and here. So that's it for now. I have to get me a 12 volt battery so I can start testing stuff. Nah, not yet. Okay, I think I got it. Friggin' bolts are tight. But there was Loctite on here. Brake lines. Well, we'll see what comes on the next one. There's some kind of plastic sleeve on here. But it's full of crud. That's why the pedal won't move, I guess. Of course, it's been, like I said, it's been sitting since 94. Full of shit.
sawdust.
See, where are we?
I like lock nuts. Might go out and buy her one of those ratcheting wrenches. I don't want to go through that again. That was a bitch. Trying to get my hand in there. I left this on. So I just put the bolts back, nuts back, so I don't lose them. It's funny, this one was really tight all the way out. This one was semi-tight. This one was pretty loose, but I couldn't get my hand on it. See, I can thread that in. What I should do. Some WD-40 in here, let it soak. That's it. That's the end of this video.